Within hours of the polls closing, Nawaz Sharif was claiming victory outside his party headquarters in Lahore. But his two previous tenures as prime minister were hardly glorious. If confirmed as prime minister for a third time, Sharif faces some major challenges at home. He says the rise in militancy and terrorism is top of his list of priorities.
He has to understand that this is an existential threat for himself, his party, and for Pakistan. The presence and legitimacy of a political party, a non-militant political party, is critical to create that necessary legitimacy which is needed to fight militancy and radicalism in the society.
Security isn't his only challenge. The energy crisis resulting in prolonged power outages is damaging industry and business and sometimes provokes street protests. The economy is also struggling. Pakistan's public finances are a mess. Sharif, a steel magnate, is a friend of business, and his likely victory has already boosted Pakistan's stock market to a record high Monday.
The classic Sharif plan is infrastructure projects. They would want to concentrate and focus on building motorways, putting up huge dams, perhaps developing urban centers, housing projects. And for that, they need a lot of capital. So, in essence, it would be deficit financing, which the IMF might not approve of. And that's one hesitancy on part of the Sharif government not to sign on the dotted line of the IMF agreement.
Sharif wants to improve relations with archenemy India. He says he had a long chat with Indian Prime Minister Manmohan Singh Sunday, but he faces a complex regional and international picture.
I think we would see some moves out of the Sharif government towards towards India, but I'm convinced that Pakistan's relationship with Afghanistan and our foreign policy with the United States is actually controlled and dominated by the Pakistan military as opposed to the civilian elected government.
So will it be third time lucky for the man dubbed the Lion of Punjab? He was forced to step down amid a dispute with the then president in 1993 and ousted in a coup by General Musharraf in 1999. This time around, Nawaz Sharif says he's matured as a politician and won't make the same mistakes again. He's cried foul in the past, claiming his governments were ousted before they could make an impact. The Pakistani people and the world are watching to see if this time his administration can go the distance in a country that so desperately needs stability. Simon Mawson, CNN, Islamabad, Pakistan.